At GoSol, we are solving the problem of access to clean energy for working people in developing world. And to do this, we have designed the Sol 5. It's a solar concentrator using 5 square meter of mirror.
When I saw it, it impressed me a lot.
We are creating sustainable income generation for people and entrepreneurs, and we do this through pilot education and trainings program. Our goal is to create sustainable income generation for low-income people. In 2017, we ran two beautiful projects in Kenya and in Tanzania with humanitarian and private partners. Our team members on the field were Lauren Symington and Heikki Lindfors. With the Sol 5 model, entrepreneurs can access a free and clean energy source, save money, and grow their business. This is what we call the direct solar economy. To finance our project, to empower entrepreneurs, we have a major partner, Wärtsilä.
We have had a long history in Africa delivering power plants for many, many years, and we are engaging in all kind of social responsibility projects, supporting healthcare, education, and another angle is supporting entrepreneurs, small entrepreneurs that hopefully then bring local business and start growing. We've looked at GoSol technology and found it very interesting. Rather simple solutions which can be applied in poor communities and built up of components, materials which can be found almost anywhere.
Sol 5 is very good. People like it is easy. It is easy to use.
In Kenya, our local partner is the NGO World Vision. And in Finland, we also work with We Economy, a program of World Vision Finland.
The word comes from me business to we business. So it's kind of we economy. We are looking for partners who want to develop sustainable, ethical business. And they have a solution or a business model that can actually benefit the children and the communities where World Vision works.
World Vision connected us with local communities. The first one was Koptige, a bakery.
I remember the day I visited the Koptige bakery in Tindred. They had an electric oven and they were using it, and they were doing it very professionally, and David was really the master, showing how they bake the bread and what is the process and so forth. But he was also explaining, like, they had those power cuts daily and even whole day without power, which was a huge problem. And the ladies of the group, they were also very telling how they came up with the vision for the group, and they want to help the community. So it's not just the group for getting income for themselves.
We have worked very well with the Sol 5 oven. Daily we are producing breads, muffin cakes, and the snacks, which are wonderfully eaten. It's wonderfully sold to several people. The oven has helped a lot, and we still need more of this.
I was so impressed about the professionalism of the group. They had a lot of orders coming in from hospitals and schools, but they could not actually supply because of that lack of constant power and only with the one electric oven.
This one is much more heavy. It's my muffin.
Yeah, looking good.
So now what they have been telling is that they have been able to expand.
Bread took 35 minutes, and normally it takes 40 minutes to be ready. We have now saved 10 minutes and produced the same bread. Yes.
10-10. 10-10. 10-10 amaro.
They have decreased their electricity usage by 70%. They actually increased their production by 50% at the same time. So now they are using the both ovens to bake more bread, to do more business. They had such a success with the solar oven that they want another one. So one of these ovens that you see here today is going to be Koptigai Bakery after this demonstration.
And we've just finished installing the second Soul 5. We're all really excited about this because we think that next year they're gonna get another Soul 5, and the year after that they're gonna get another Soul 5, because they're selling out of bread every single day. More and more of that bread is gonna be baked by our Soul 5s.
Instead of buying charcoal, we use this, huh?
Look at that! The first kg of solar peanut butter.
The fishermen of Bau Beach are catching sardines, Nile perch, and tilapia fish. With traditional fish drying methods on the ground, under the sun, lots of fish get spoiled and the fish rot instead of dry. Now with the Soul 5 solar dehydrator, it changes everything.
There's lots of power, right? If 5 square meters can run a small business, think about what Kenya could do. Right? How much surface area is in Kenya? How much industry could you power with this? It's not only about small business, it's also about a whole host of applications. Anything that uses heat can be powered by these machines.
In Tanzania, with our local partner, the NGO Global Resource Alliance, we were introduced to local communities.
Global Resource Alliance Tanzania has 4 main activities. We drill boreholes, we look after orphans. We have a project where we distribute seedlings for planting trees. We have an alternative medicine unit. The problem of charcoal is very straightforward. 90% of Tanzania's energy needs, and especially cooking, domestic cooking, is met by the use of charcoal. Only 2% of our energy needs are met by the use of electricity. Of the 40 or so million hectares of land, about 320,000 is decimated every year by the use of charcoal.
We're at the Environmental Expo in town of Butiama in Mara region, and we have brought here the first Soul 5 baking oven in Tanzania.
Great.
Yeah, so
innovation.
Thank you. Yeah. It's our solution to deforestation problem here.
Oh yeah. I'll look for you later.
Okay,
yeah,
thank you, madam.
I want to learn more about it.
Increasing the income generation in any community benefits, I would say, all. That helps to raise the, I would say, standard of living, and feeds an economy anywhere, and keeps on rolling if you get it to start.
Ah!
By spreading the Sol5 technology, all the Gosol team is committed to fight against climate change, deforestation, and energy poverty. The technology has a lot of impacts on health, on economy, and environment. And when people can every day produce what they need with a clean solar energy, this is what we call a direct solar economy.